Christ. Have I not sent him? Gideon was sent as a savior. The word savior means deliverer. The word savior there means destroyer. There is no way Gideon can save Israel from the Midianite without destruction. Gideon was sent to destroy the gods of the land and enthrone the Almighty God so that the land will be delivered. So the mandate of each Gideon was to go and destroy and save. So let me begin by saying this, that for every problem that men are going through, there is a cause. It's either you are the cause or somebody was the cause before you. There are inherited troubles. The trouble of Israel was the trouble of their fathers. It was their fathers that began the day. But their kingdom came to start paying for it. Because in Judges 6 and verse 6, the Bible says, the entire Israel became so impoverished. So one of the causes of poverty is because of enemy. The reason for poor or poverty in this country, they are enemies. Enemies of the country is what have made the country poor. Enemies of your family is what have incurred or poverty upon your family. But tonight, everyone against your progress expire today. Gideon got the mandate to go and save the children of Israel. Let's see how he saved them. Verse 25. Let's go to verse 25 quickly. See how Gideon saved them, verse 25. And it came to pass, somebody said the same night. Which night? It came to pass the same night that the Lord said unto him. Remember verse 14. Verse 25, the Lord said unto him, take thy father's young bullock, even the seven bullock, the second bullock of the seven. Yes, and throw down. Someone say throw down. I like my other versions of the Bible. You see, sometimes King James is lenient. King James is trying to use words. Other versions say go and destroy. King James say go and throw down. Other versions of the Bible say go and destroy. Go and destroy.
Okay.
say raise a new one?
Yes.
When you destroy these altars, raise a new one.
Yes.
Verse 27. The Bible said Gideon took 10 men. And it was night. Gideon took how many men? He took 10 men.
Yes.
And they went at night.
Yes,
what did they do? They went at night and destroyed all the altars.
Yes.
The church there is a problem. Gideon destroyed altar, he didn't destroy people. So the people stood against him.
Yes, sir.
Let's read Bible. The reason why I will show you about Jehu. Because Jehu destroyed both altar and people. Gideon only destroyed altar, he didn't destroy people. Church, let me show you some things. The Bible says Gideon took 10 men, he went and destroyed. Go to verse 28, quickly, let's go. He go to, and when the men of the city arose in the morning, Gideon only destroyed the altar, he didn't kill the priest. It's dangerous if you destroy altar and you don't destroy the priest. Because the priest will come after your life.
Yes, sir.
When I get to Jehu, I will show you how Jehu raised down both the altar and the people.
Yes.
So his full reign was slain. But immediately Gideon pulled down the altar, he didn't destroy the people. The Bible says in the morning the people still woke up. The people still woke up. Because he didn't destroy them, he only destroyed the altar. When they woke up in the morning, behold, the altar was cast down and the groups fell down. And the second block and everything offered upon the altar that was built. Go to verse 29. Look, and they said one to another, who had done this? Who did you not? Look, tonight I came not to fight only the altar.
Yes.
I came to destroy the altar and the priest.
Yes.
Every man or woman servicing the altar must die tonight. Look at it. Then the men of the city said unto them, bring out thy son that he may die. If Gideon had destroyed both the altar and the people, nobody would have fought him.
Yes, sir.
I don't know. Our next reading and deliverance will say this next week, right?
Yes, sir.
I will show you that of Jehu. But let me rest here tonight. Let me show you some few things there. Jehu went after the altar and the people. He went after all of them, not just Jezebel alone. All the priests of the Jehu did something. He sent all the priests of Baal and all the people. Let all of them gather in the place, both the worshipper, the priest and the worshipper, and the servants of Baal. He said all of them should gather in one place, and all of them gather. He said he wants to cook for them, that they should come and eat.
Yeah.
Then Jehu gathered all of them in one place, and after all of them have gathered, what that is when he said, kill everybody.
Yes.
Nobody is there.
Yes.
So that is the anointing.
Yes.
The anointing that is here.
Yes.
It will destroy both the satanic altar.
Yes.
The priest shall visit the altar.
Yes.
Every altar that is against you.
Yes.
The altar I raise it up on fire. The priest in charge of the altar of dying tonight.
Yes.
Where did Jehovah come from? Let's go to Jehovah. Go to verse 31 now. When they say, go and look for the people now. And Jehovah said unto them, Jehovah said unto all that stood against him, against Gideon. He said, will you plead for her? I said, come back, be God, but if Baal be God, let Baal plead for himself. Let Baal go after the person that pleads for himself. And that was how verse 32. He said, Gideon is called Jehovah. Go to the church, can we read now? Therefore, on that day, he called Gideon, Jehovah, saying, let Baal plead against him, because he has thrown down the altar of tonight, I stand here with the Jehovah that anointed. The anointing of the strong, the anointing of the rest. That's all by the throne. that power was not power for, it's power against. Have you ever seen it? The Bible says he gave me power against unclean spirits. That word unclean spirit means satanic gods. Every ionic gods. Every gods of the land. Every foul spirit. Every evil god. Let I have power against them. What do I do with the power that you are giving to me? Verse 5, he spoke to me, said my son, carry that power, go forward, carry that power, go ahead. And verse 8, he began to speak to me, he said, with that power, begin to touch sickness, with that power, begin to change leprosy, with that power, begin to change the spirit of pain, he said, with that power, begin to deliver and get it now. I don't know what is bothering you. Lift up your head again, all ye gate, ye ancient gods, that the King of glory may come in. I don't know the gate of the heaven, I don't know the gate of the glory of my head. Therefore, my eyes stand by the anointing, the gentleman anointing over my life. And I command those gates be lifted up. They want to. When the noise enter, they come, they are dead. Come on.